Today, I'm going to talk about conductors and insulators. Here is a small list. As you all know, conductors are the materials which allow sound, heat, and electricity to pass through them, whereas insulators does not allow. This is the list: good conductors, fair conductors, and insulators. All the metals, silver, copper, gold, iron, these are good conductors, whereas carbon, acid solution, salt water, and water vapor, they are fair conductors. Here is the oil, fur, silk, rubber, and wool. These are insulators. Now, if we talk about the internal structure of insulators, semiconductors, and conductors, it is like this. There are two types of band present in almost all the types of material. These are valence band and conduction band. If we see in insulator, there is a big energy gap in between valence band and conduction band. This energy gap is known as band gap. So the electrons from the valence band are not able to jump in the conduction band when we supply electricity through it. But if you see in semiconductor, the gap, this band gap is less compared to the insulator. So some of the electrons are able to jump from valence band to conduction band. Now, if we see in conductor, how it is. In conductor, there is no gap. There is no band gap between valence band and conduction band. So the electrons are easily moving through both the bands. So they are able to carry the electrical energy through the material. Here I have made a simple circuit which we can use to test the material which we have to test about the conductors or insulators. This is a DC source. This is bulb. This is a place where we can keep the material to test, and this is a switch. Now we'll see through a small experiment how the materials can be categorized in conductors and insulators. Here I have taken some of the material: metal, wood, pencil lead, salt solution, sugar solution, oil. So first I'll take metal. Let's see. Bulb is glowing brightly, so this is a good conductor. This is a wooden piece. Bulb is not at all glowing, so this is an insulator. This is a pencil lead. We all know it is made up from graphite and it is a very good conductor. So you can see that the bulb is still glowing very brightly. Now I'll take some solution. First I will take salt solution. Mix some salt in it. And put the alligator clip inside. You can see the brightness in the LED. It is glowing but with very dim brightness. I'll take another solution, that is sugar solution. When we put the alligator clip inside, we have to be very careful because the vessel is a metal. So if it touch the bottom of the vessel, definitely the bulb will glow brightly. Now you can see there is a very dim light in the LED. It means it is a conductor but conducting very, very less. Now I'll take oil. This is a vegetable oil, and as we know, vegetable oil is an insulator. Let's see. Again, there is no any brightness or glow in the LED. So this vegetable oil is an insulator. Thank you.